ओके हाय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू डायमंड ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूशंस नीट एंड केसेट ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। सो नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चंस रे ऑप्टिक्स। ओके ना, सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज ए कॉनकेव मिरर फॉर फेस वीविंग। ओके, कॉनकेव मिरर फॉर फेस वीविंग हैज फोकल लेंथ ऑफ 0.4 मीटर। फोकल लेंथ गिवेन 0.4 मीटर। सो कॉनकेव मिरर को फोकल लेंथ इज नेगेटिव, दैट इज एफ इक्वल टू -0.4 मीटर्स। ओके, द डिस्टेंस एट विच यू होल्ड द मिरर फ्रॉम योर फेस, एट विच यू हैव टू होल्ड द मिरर फ्रॉम योर फेस इन ऑर्डर टू सी योर इमेज अपराइट विथ ए मैग्निफिकेशन ऑफ 5 इज। वी हैव टू गेट द अपराइट इमेज, दैट मीन्स वर्चुअल इमेज वी हैव टू गेट एंड 5 टाइम्स टू द ऑब्जेक्ट फेस। ओके, ना मैग्निफिकेशन इज +5। वाई आई एम टेकिंग द +5 मीन्स अपराइट इमेज, फॉर अपराइट इमेज +5 एंड इन्वर्टेड इमेज -5। ओके माइनस, ओके नाउ दे गिवन द अपराइट, सो प्लस, सो दे आर आस्किंग द मैग्निफिकेशन गिवन एंड फोकल लेंथ गिवन, दे आर आस्किंग द व्हाट इज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द मिरर एंड फेस, दैट इज ओनली दे आर आस्किंग एट विच यू होल्ड द डिस्टेंस एट विच यू होल्ड द मिरर फ्रॉम योर फेस, यू ऑब्जेक्ट डिस्टेंस वी हैव टू फाइंड। दिस इज द ऑब्जेक्ट मिरर, इट इज फॉर्मिंग द इमेज अपराइट इमेज एंड द मैग्निफिकेशन ऑफ द इमेज इज 5 टाइम्स टू द दिस फेस। Then what is the distance between the mirror and image, mirror and face we have to find. So direct formula we know, m equal to the f by f minus u for the mirrors, this is for the mirrors, remember. Okay, so already in the first video I explained on the ray optics, already I taught two videos, once you see that one, watch that one. Okay, m equal to f by f minus u, m value is +5 and f value is -0.4, f value is -0.4, this is the u. Okay, now this one sent to the side, -5 into -0.4 -2, 5 into minus u -5u equal to right side we have the -0.4. now -5u send this side, it will become positive, -0.4 send that side, it will become positive. So +5u equal -2 + 0.4 -1.6, -1.6, u equal to -1.6/5, so that is equal to 0.32. here focal length in terms of the meter, so this is also in terms of the meter, 0.32 meters. C option is the right answer. Very easy problem, just remember the formula, enough, mains level question. Next, see a transparent cube of side D. Actually, this is not mains level question, but asked in the mains exam. Okay, next, cube of side D made of a material of refractive index mu2. Okay, this is the glass. They given diagram also. This is the transparent cube of side D, and refractive index of this one is the mu2. Is immersed in a liquid of refractive index mu1. Okay, this surrounding medium is the mu1. And the glass ka refractive index mu2. A ray is incident on the face AB. Okay, na this is the face, this is the ABC. Okay, AB face may incident at an angle theta. Okay, here angle theta according to the diagram. TIR, total internal reflection takes place at point E. Okay, at this point total internal reflection takes place on the face BC, and face BC, this is the face BC. At E point, total internal reflection takes place. Total internal reflection means without the loss of any energy, the ray totally reflected into the same medium. Then theta must satisfy. This theta must satisfy. Okay, now this theta value we have to find. Okay, here we have the two cases. One case is here, one more case is here. So here the angle is greater than the critical angle. If incident angle is greater than the critical angle, then the ray should be takes place, total internal reflection takes place. If critical angle, incident angle is equal to the critical angle, then it will graze this surface. But here it is total internal reflection taking place now. So then incident angle is greater than the critical angle at the E point. Okay. Now at the E point, I am using the Snell's law, and from that I am going to find, see now. Critical angle equal to how much I am going to find here. Here the critical angle equal to the, already we know the critical angle formula, sin IC or sin C equal to the refractive index of the rarer medium by the refractive index of the denser medium. So here surrounding medium is a rarer medium. The mu1 is less than mu2, the given a condition, surrounding medium is a rarer medium and the refractive index of the glass is the denser medium. So sin c equal to the refractive index of the rarer medium by the refractive index of the denser medium. So rarer medium ka refractive index mu 1, denser medium ka refractive index is mu 2. Now at this point the critical angle is sin c equal to mu 1 by mu 2. One condition completed, one case. Now one more place here, taking refraction here taking now. So I am using the Snell's law here. From this Snell's law, already I said in the previous videos, the refractive index of this medium into sine of angle in that medium equal to the refractive index of this medium into sine of angle in that medium. Okay. So in this medium, surrounding medium is the water, liquid. Refractive index mu 1 into angle is here, sine of angle of incident is sine theta. So mu 1 into sine theta equal to refractive index this medium mu 2 into angle here. What is this angle? Now I'm extend this ray here, this ray here. This is making the 90 degrees. Okay. Suppose here the angle equal to the C. Now this angle is should be equal to the 90 minus C. Okay, I am writing here mu 2 into sine of angle here is the 90 minus C. Okay, so now sine theta equal to mu 1 send this side. So mu 2 by mu 1 into sine 90 minus C, C is nothing but the cos C. Do it carefully, simplification. Sine theta equal to mu 2 by mu 1 into cos C, we can write it as the square root of 1 minus sine square t. That means sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1 cos square theta equal to 1 minus sine square theta cos theta equal to the square root of 1 minus sine square theta. From that, cos C equal to square root of 1 minus sine square C. So sin theta equal to mu 2 by mu 1 into 1 square root of 1 minus sin C value already we found mu 1 by mu 2. So sin square C na mu 1 square by mu 2 square. So now this one send into the root. Then what will be happen? This will become square. So now sin theta equal to mu 2 mu 1 I am sending into the square root. Then it will become square. So mu 2 by mu 1 whole square. Square square root will cancel out. Then we will get this value only. Nothing will happen. So I am sending this one into the square root. So mu 2 mu 1 whole square. Remaining term same. 1 minus mu 1 square by mu 2 square. Sin theta equal. I am multiplying inside. Mu 2 square by mu 1 square into 1. Same mu 2 square by mu 1 square minus. This mu 2 square by mu 1 square into mu 1 square by mu 2 square. Cancel out. We will get the 1. Okay. Now theta value we know onto. Theta equal to sine inverse of square root of mu 2 square by mu 1 square minus 1. This is the theta value we got. Here condition theta is greater than or theta is less than. So here if I is greater than the critical angle, if incident angle increases, okay, if incident angle increases, here the angle should be decreases. Here angles decreases, this theta also will decrease. That means here for the maximum angle, this should theta should be minimum. Remember that one. Here total internal reflection takes place for the maximum angle of the incident only. If the angle of incident is greater than the critical angle, then total internal reflection takes place. So here incident angle is the maximum. So here maximum means here theta should be minimum. Theta should be minimum means theta is less than this value. We got theta is this value now. So this should be less than this value. Then total internal reflection takes place. Why? Because in this case we assume the I equal to the C. We assumed I equal to C and we did the total. But here condition is actually I is greater than the C. If I is greater than the C, theta should be less than whatever the value we are getting. So the theta should be less than the sine inverse of mu 2 square by mu 1 square minus 1. Theta less than sine inverse. So D option is the right answer. Okay, in this way solve the question. Concentrate this type of questions maximum in NEET exam or JEE mains. They are asking the questions based on this concept only. Do more and more problems based on this concept. Next, a ray of light AO in vacuum is incident on a glass slab at an angle 60 degree. Okay, AO diagram they given AO 60 degree with incidenting angle at 60 degree and reflected at an angle 30 degree. Reflected not refracted here. Refracted at an angle 30 degree along OB as shown. The optical path length of light ray from A to B, from here to here, the optical path length we have to find. Okay, now see, this is the 60 degrees. Now this is the normal for this surface. This angle is nothing but the 30 degrees. Okay, so this length they given A, this is also they given B, total everything is given. This is the diagram they given. Just I am using this diagram and so this is the 60 now. So then I will get the 30. This one sine 30 equal to the opposite side by hypotenuse. Sine 30 equal to opposite side is the A and from here to here length the AO. From this AO equal to 2. AO ka value we got. And next come to this side. So this is we If you use the sine 30 opposite side by this side no need, no use, okay? Nah? So this side we know and this side we have to find. So cos 30 is a suitable here. Cos 30 equal to the adjacent side by hypotenuse, B by OB. So B by OB. So OB equal to the cos 30 value is root 3 by 2, so inside side 2 by root 3 into B. So AO value, OB value we got, OB value we got, okay? Nah? And next we have to find the refractive index of this glass. What is the refractive index of this one? Apply the Snell's law at this point. Refractive index of this mu 1 into sine angle made with the normal 60, sine 60 equal to the mu 2 into angle made with the normal 30, so sine 30. Mu 1, vacuum now, vacuum ka refractive index is 1, sine 60 root 3 by 2 equal to mu 2 is the refractive index of this glass into sine 30. Okay, so root 3 by 2 equal to the mu 2 into sine 30 1 by 2, mu 2 value 2 cancel, mu 2 equal to root 3. Refractive index of this medium we are getting the root 3. Okay, why I found the root refractive index of that medium also I will tell. Optical path, to find the optical path in a medium equal to the refractive index of that medium into length traveled by the light ray. Okay, na? Refractive index of that medium into length traveled by wave in that medium equal to the optical path. Now they are asking the optical path from A to B. Na? Here we have the two mediums, two different mediums. One is a vacuum, one more is the glass. So refractive index of the vacuum into ray traveled in this medium. Okay, na? Okay, here I am writing mu 1 into ray traveled in that medium is the OA plus refractive index of this medium mu 2 into ray traveled in this medium is the OB. Then this will give the optical path. Optical path equal to the refractive index of that medium into ray traveled in that medium. Simply you have to remember. Vacuum ka refractive index 1, OA value is 2A, 1 into 2A, 2A. Mu 2 value, this glass ka refractive index we found already root 3, root 3 into OB value is, OB we found 2 by root 3, B, 2 by root 3, root 3 will be cancelled. We will get the 2A plus 2B. So optical path, okay, na? The optical path length of the light ray from A to B equal to how much? 2A plus 2B. 2A plus 2B, C option is the right answer. So in this way you have to solve the problems, easy questions. See the next question, fourth question. A ball is dropped from a height of 20 meter above the surface of water in a lake. The refractive index of water is 4 by 3. A fish inside the lake in the line of fall of the ball is looking at the ball at an instant when the ball is 12.8 meter above the water surface. The fish sees the speed of the ball as. Okay, speed of the ball we have to find here. Okay, na? So see now, I draw on the diagram here. So this is the lake. From this lake, the ball is at the 20 meter height. Okay. Now this ball is dropped from this height. Whenever this this is above the 12.8 meter above the surface, this fish saw this ball. Then what is the speed of that ball appear to this fish? We have to find that one. Okay, see now total height above the surface is 20 meter. Now whenever this fish observed this ball, it is at that instant the height above the surface is 12.8. Then what is the height from here to here? 7.2 meters. So it dropped from here, then to reach the 7.2 meter, whenever it reached, passed through the 7.2 meters, then what is the velocity we have to find? Now ball is dropped here, so it is freely falling under the gravity. So then speed at this point to find the formula equal to V equal to the root 2gh formula. Okay, now V equal to root 2gh formula I am using. 2g value is the 10h, how much distance it traveled? 7.2 meters. So 7.2 meter, then speed equal to 12 meter per second. So whenever it reaches to this height, then the speed is a 12 meter per second. That means actually the speed when the fish observe the ball at the distance from the surface is 12.8 meter, actual speed is 12 meter per second. What is the speed appear to this fish we have to find. So now the fish is in the water and this ball is in the space vacuum. Okay, free space or vacuum, this is in the water. That means the fish is observing the object from denser medium to the rarer medium. if we see the anything from the denser medium to the rarer medium, it will appear, suppose if we consider distance, the distance appear more than the actual distance, okay na? So we are viewing from the here actual distance is 12.8. if you view from the denser medium, it will appear more than this one, okay? So if you are observing from the denser medium, the speed at this point is 12 meter per second. If you see from denser medium, the speed appear more than this 12 meter per second. How much that we have to find? So from here to here, this is the apparent depth. Now apparent height, the apparent height equal to the 12. Apparent height we have to find. Actual height is 12.8 meters. What is the apparent height? So apparent height equal to the mu into x is the real height. Okay, if you are viewing from the denser medium to the rarer medium, apparent height is more than the actual height. Okay, if you are viewing from the rarer to the denser, rarer to denser, then apparent height is less than the actual height. More than the actual height, now from denser to the rarer, that's why we have to multiply. Less means divide by the refractive index. Already in the first video I said that points. So now differentiate this one with respect to the time. So dx apparent by dt equal to refractive index of the medium is the constant. So now mu into dx by dt, this is the real depth, okay? So now apparent rate of change of apparent height is equal to the apparent velocity of apparent velocity equal to the mu into dx by dt is nothing but the speed, actual speed at that instant we have to find. So mu value is the water car refractive index is 4/3, and at this point actual speed equal to the 12 meter per second, and substitute we will get the apparent speed is 16 meter per second. That means at this point actual speed is 12 meter per second, but this speed appearing to this fish is more than that. That means it is as a 16 meter per second. Okay, and next come to see the next question. One plano convex and one plano concave lens of same radius of curvature are but of different materials are joined side by side. So they given the diagram, see now. So this is the plano convex and this one is the plano concave. Okay, now this is the second plano concave and this is the plano convex. Two lenses are combined, both have the same refractive index R. Okay, but two different materials. This have the refractive refractive index is mu 1 and for this one refractive index is the mu 2. Okay, if the refractive index of the material of one is mu 1 and the refractive index of second is mu 2, then the focal length of the combination, this combination ka focal length we have to find. So from the lens maker's formula, already we know focal length formula is 1 by f equal to the mu minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. So first this is plano convex, na for this one we have to apply the lens maker's formula. So for this one focal length is f1, I am assuming 1 by f1 equal to the refractive index of this one is mu1, mu1 minus 1 into 1 by r1. This is the first curve, this is the first surface, so refractive index radius of curvature is infinity, so 1 by infinity. Yeah, minus is there, na? But this curve, radius of curvature in this direction, that is the R. So ray is coming in this direction. We are measuring the radius of curvature opposite to the direction to take the negative. So minus of minus plus, we will get to radius of curvature of this curved part is the R. So 1 by R. From this 1 by F1 equal to mu 1 minus 1 into 1 by infinity value is a 0 plus 1 by R. So 1 by R. We got this one. 1 by F1 equal to mu 1 minus 1 into 1 by R. Next, apply the same lens maker's formula to this plano concave lens. Okay, na? So for this one, 1 by f2 equal to the mu2. The refractive index of this one is the mu2. Mu2 minus 1 into first surface is this one. So radius of curvature is r. So opposite direction negative. So minus 1 by r. So for this plano, radius of curvature is infinity. Minus 1 by infinity equal to 1 by f2 into. So minus 1 by this term will become 0. So minus 1 by r multiply this one. Minus mu2 minus 1 by r. So the refractive index of this combination equal to the 1 by f equal to 1 by f1 plus 1 by f2. So 1 by f1 value substitute mu1 minus 1 by r. Mu1 minus 1 by r. And 1 by f2 value is minus mu2 minus 1 by r. So minus here I am writing mu2 minus 1 by r. 1 by r is the common. So minus 1 here, minus into minus plus 1 cancel out. We will get mu1 minus mu2. So from this f equal to the reverse it. R by mu minus 1. R by mu minus 1. Okay, easy question. Previous year mains question. Easy question but asked in the mains exam. Okay, next question. An object is at a distance of 20 meter. Object distance given u equal to minus 20 meter. From a convex lens, of focal length is 0.3 meter. Convex lens of focal length is positive. That is given 0.3 meters. And the object moves away from the lens at a speed of 5 meter per second. So here object is moving away from the lens. If the object is moving away from the lens, image will move toward the lens. Remember that point. So from these options, away, toward. Toward. So these two chances are there, but these two are the wrong options. Away from. If object is moving away from the lens, image will move toward the lens. Remember that point. From that, these two options will be wrong, and first two options, which is right answer, we have to select. So object ka velocity they given du by dt. Okay, the rate of du by dt means don't think u is the velocity in kinematics. Here u is the object to distance in the optics. Du by dt means rate of change of object to distance. So object to speed 20 meter per second. It is moving away from the lens. So if it is moving away from the lens, I have to consider as a plus. Then moving toward the means minus we have to get. So what we are getting, we have to see this one. See now, from the mirror's lens formula, 1 by f equal to 1 by b minus 1 by u. So differentiate with respect to the time, focal length not changes, so 0. So 1 by v ka differentiation is minus 1 by v square dv by dt, and 1 by u ka differentiation minus 1 by u square, minus into minus plus 1 by u square du by dt. So now minus 1 by v square, since this side it will become plus. So 1 by v square into dv by dt equal to 1 by u square du by dt. So from this we have to find the speed of the image. So dv by dt we have to find. So speed dv by dt equal to v square, same this side, v by u whole square into du by dt. V by u is nothing but magnification in lenses, is nothing but v by u. That is nothing but f by f plus u. In mirrors f by f minus u, in lenses f by f plus u. Remember dv by dt equal to the, why I am writing here this formula means the given data is u given, f given. So v value not given, that's why I am writing in terms of that one. So v by u plus me, I am writing f by f plus u whole square du by dt. F value is 0.3 and u value is minus 20 and du by dt value is 20. Substitute and simplify, we will get the answer minus 1.16 into 10 power minus 3 meter per second. Here du by theta I consider plus, that means it is moving away from the lens. Here I got minus means opposite to this one, moving away from. So object is moving away from this one, negative sign is indicated that moving toward the lens. So 1.16 into 10 power minus 3 meter per second toward the lens. D option is the right answer. In this way solve the problems. See the next question. A convex lens of focal length 20 centimeter, convex lens ka focal length is positive, so f equal to 20 centimeter, produces images of the same magnification 2 when an object is kept at two distances x1 and x2 from the lens. So the ratio of x1 and x2 is, so for the two distances we are getting the same magnification, means it may be plus or it may be minus, m is plus or minus 2, and two distances x1 x2 we have to find. So distance, object distance they are asking, magnification they given, focal length they given, the relationship between these three is m equal to f by f plus u. Okay, now this formula is very important. For lenses m equal to f by f plus u, for mirrors m equal to f by f minus u. So first I am considering first case mein minus 2 and the second case mein I am considering the plus 2. First case mein distance is x1 object distance, second case mein object distance is the x2. Now I am substituting the value m equal to minus 2, f value 20, 20 by 20 plus x1, second case mein m value is plus 2, 20 by 20 plus x2. Simplification. This send this side, minus 2 into 20 minus 40 minus 2 into x1 minus 2x1 equal to 20. So minus 2x1 send this side, plus 2x1 equal to plus 20, send this side minus 60, x1 equal to minus 30 centimeter. So to get the magnification equal to the minus 2, the object distance should be 30 centimeter from the lens. Now here cross multiplication, plus 2 into 20 plus 40 plus 2 into x2 plus 2x2 equal to the 20. 2x2 equal to 40 centimeter, it will become minus, minus 40 plus 20 minus 20, s2 equal to minus 10 centimeter. To get the magnification plus 2, we have to keep the object at the 10 centimeter from the lens. They are asking the ratio of x1 and x2. So x1 value minus 30, x2 value minus 10, x1 by x2 equal to minus 30 by minus 10, 3:1. 3:1 is the right answer. So this formula is a very important to solve so many problems based on this formula only. Next problem, see now. A thin convex lens made from chrome glass. okay, na? It is made from the crown glass and refractive index of that one is measure equal to 3/2. They given the refractive index. Has focal length f. Okay, it has the focal length is f. When it is measured in two different liquids having the refractive indices 4/3 and 5/3, it has focal lengths f1 and f2 respectively. The correct relation between the focal length is, first focal length of this lens in the air we have to find. Next we have to find the focal lengths in the two different liquids. Next we have to find the relationship between the two focal lengths. First see, glass ka refractive, the convex lens ka refractive index is 3/2. I am assuming that is in the air now. So now focal length from the lens maker's formula, 1 by f equal to 1 by f equal to mu minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. See, this mu value already in the first video I said to you, this mu is the refractive index of the lens with respect to the medium. That means refractive index of the lens by refractive index of the medium. Okay, so according to that, 1 by f equal to refractive index of the lens with respect to the medium. First case, what I am assuming, it is in the air. So air ka refractive index is 1. So refractive index of lens by medium. Medium ka 1, lens. So lens ka kitna? 3/2. So 3/2 by 1 means 3/2. 3/2 minus 1. 1/2. So 1/2 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. Whenever it is in the air, the focal length f, 1 by f equal to 1/2 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. First condition completed. Next, it immersed in the two different liquids. First liquid I am considering. So whenever the refractive index is 4/3, then focal length is f1, and whenever the refractive index is 5/3, then focal length is f2. So now refractive index mu1 equal to 4/3, then focal length f1 equal to 1/f1 equal to, here already I said refractive index of the lens to the medium. Lens ka refractive index 3/2 by medium ka refractive index is 4/3 minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2 equal to 1/f1 equal to 3/2 by 4/3 equal to 9/8. 9/8 minus 1, 1/8. So 1/8 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. We have to do the simplification. Okay, so second liquid ka refractive index is 5/3, then focal length is f2. So 1/f2 equal to the refractive index of the lens by refractive index of the medium. Lens ka refractive index is 3/2, medium ka refractive index is 5/3, minus 1 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. 3/2 by 5/3 means 9/10. 9/10 minus 1 is minus 1/10. So minus 1/10 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. Okay, so now in the air refractive index is focal length, in the air focal length is f, we got f1, we got f2, okay, f1 f2 we got. So from that I am writing 1/f1 equal to 1/8 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. Now from this, see, now first whenever it is in the air, 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2 equal to, what we can write, 2, send this at 2 by f. At the place of 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2, we can write 2 by f. So 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2 placement, 2 by f I am writing, simplifying, I am getting 2 ones, 2 fours. 1 by f1 equal to 1 by 4f, f1 equal to the 4f. Same from the f2 case also, 1 by f2 equal to the minus 1 by 10 into 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2. From this one, what we are getting, 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2 equal to 2 by f. So 2 by f. So 2 ones, 2 fives, it will be cancelled. F2 equal to the minus 5f I am getting. So here the relationship between this, see, now f1 is greater than the f. Why? Because f1 equal to the 4f. And f2 we are getting negative. F2 is a negative. See, f1 equal to f2. So wrong option this one. F1 is greater than f and f2 is negative. B is the right option. Okay, na? So option B is the right answer. No need to see remaining options also. If you want, see it. Next, see the next question. In an experiment for determination of refractive index of a glass prism by I del plot, okay, incident angle and deviation angle ka plot, it was found that a ray incident at an angle of 35 degrees, incident angle I1 equal to the 35 degrees, suffers a deviation of 40 degrees, deviation del equal to the 40 degrees, and that it emerges at an angle 79 degrees. So emerging angle I2 equal to the 79 degrees. Some books I2, some books E also they will give, okay, na, emergent angle. That case, when which of the following is closest to the maximum possible value of the refractive index? Refractive index we have to find. Here they didn't mention about the minimum deviation or whatever it is, not mentioned. So now deviation formula equal to I1 plus I2 minus R1 plus R2. Already we know this formula, remember. And one more formula is R1 plus R2 equal to the angle of prism, also we know A. So deviation value is 40 I1 value incident angle 35, I2 is the emergent angle 79, minus R1 plus R2 is nothing but the angle of prism A. From that we got the angle of prism A value equal to the 74 degrees. So we have to find the mu value. Mu A formula already we know for the prism, mu equal to sin A plus del by 2 by sin A by 2. So A value we have to find, del value we know deviation, A value we have to find, A value I found here. Now substitute the value, sin A value 74 plus deviation is 40 they given by 2 by sin of A by 2, A value 74, 74 by 2. So substitute and simplify it, we will get the mu value equal to the mu value equal to 1.51. So they are asking the maximum possible value. Closest to that value 1.51, the closest value is 1.5. The refractive index of the prism is 1.5. In this way solve the problems and thank you.